give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Wakar Kodash, Salakim. Double honor to the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone for teaching word, the truth and sincerity, and for proving well. Salutations to our fellow auntie, comes from four corners of the globe, preaching in the name of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. We out here another weekend, the Wadi Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, another live stream preaching. You got any scripture, you got anything to say, brother, go ahead and bring it out, okay? Yeah, we're coming into a time of persecution for the ones that love Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, man. And even for two-thirds, man. Okay? Jacob's trouble is fastly approaching. Okay, you got the SPLC, the Southern Poverty Law Center, labeling us as a so-called black nationalist hate group, which we're not a black nationalist hate group. We're not about nationalism of black people. We're about the Israelites. People on this sign that you see right here, we're the children of Israel. Okay, people on this sign right here, we're the children of Israel. You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, we're the Israelites the Bible speaks of. But because we're preaching the truth, like the Iowa Christ said, you know that he says, because I preach the truth, I'm the enemy of the enemy, because I preach the truth, put that up. By your enemy, because I'm the truth. That's right, we're the enemy, because we're preaching the truth, man. Okay? When we come out here, we're not talking about bringing all black people together, no. We're talking about the elected Israel, the people on this side here. Which, you so-called Negroes, you are the tribe of Judah, man. Okay? Then you got the tribes of Asher, Issachar, you so-called Latinos, tribe of Gad and Reuben, you so-called Native Indians. Okay?
Galatians 4 and 16. Go ahead. Galatians.
Yeah, Galatians 4 and 16. Yep, Galatians 4 and 16. Because we preach the truth, now we're labeled as terrorists. We're labeled as fear mongers. But wait a minute, man. All we're doing is reading out the Bible, man. We're not telling nobody to grab up their arms. We just preach it to you with prophecy of what's going to happen. Right?
Galatians chapter 4 verse 16, and therefore, Salakia, and I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth.
Read up. Verse 15.
Galatians 4 verse 15. Where is then the blessedness you speak of? For I bear your record that if it had been possible, you would have plucked out your own eyes and have given them to me. Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth?
Yeah, and are we like Paul, like Yahweh Shah, like the apostles and the elders, are we become your enemy because we speak the truth? We telling you so-called Negroes and Latinos, Native Americans, get it like the Bible. That's the truth. But why are we become your enemy because of that? We telling you so-called blacks and Latinos and Native Americans that salvation has come unto you, man. But are we the enemy because of that? We're made a mockery, a spectacle unto the world. We're not telling nobody to go out and grab guns. We're not telling nobody to go out and do anything carnal, man. Hey, the weapons of our warfare are spiritual. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, okay? But they label us as a hate. See, the white man, the so-called white man, see, he's starting off with the elite. He wants us to be separate. He wants you to be black, Latino, Native American. He wants you to be a stick, a nigga, a wetback. That's what he wants. He was cool with that. As long as you was in that mindset, he had no problem with you, man. Now that you're coming back to your nationality, he has a problem with that, man. Okay? He has a problem with that. No. Go to Revelation. Because right now, like I said, like you're saying, you know, we're labeled as this so-called hate group. Listen, man, the Most High hates, man. But you refuse to hear that. The Most High is a separatist. But you refuse to hear that. The God of the Bible is a separatist. But you refuse to hear that.
That guy is a false prophet. That's Joel Osteen.
That's right, man. And then you got these false prophets set up to lie to the children of Israel, man. To lie to the people, telling you that God loves everybody. But then when you go to the scriptures, you find out that when you even call God and Jesus, which his name is Yahweh and Yahweh Shai, they don't love everybody, not even their own people.
That's right.
Only the elect of Israel is going to make it up out of here, man. We're warning you of the destruction that's about to come. We're telling you about the World War III. We're telling you about the mark of the beast, which is the RFID chip, which they're trying to make the hip thing to do now. We're telling you about race riots, famine, death, destruction. We're warning you about the day of the Lord. Okay? But we're the enemy. That's okay. We'll wear those shoes, man, because Yahweh Shai wore those same shoes, man. And he already warned us of this to come. So go ahead and read.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 2, verse 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer.
Yeah, don't fear none of these things. We're going to suffer. We're going to be persecuted in the cities. Our own people are going to come up against us. We're going to be casted out, treated as outcasts, looked as crazy. Fear none of those things. Keep reading.
Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison.
Now, is that talking about a guy a red God covered in red paint with horns sticking out his head and a goddamn pitchfork in his hand? No. That's talking about the so-called white man, the deceiver. Okay? He's going to start up to elite. They're going to come down on Jake using their military force. They're going to come down on Jake using their media. They're gonna come down on Jake using their media. Okay? They're infiltrators, man.
Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison.
The devil shall cast some of us into prison, man. Whether that's a FEMA camp, whether that's a regular boat, prison. The Lord told us to fear none of those things, man. Because how about Shinawa Shai is with us?
That's right.
He's with us. So whatever we go through in this truth, he's going to deliver us from that, man. And whatever we go through is to build our faith up, man. But right now, we've been on the mark, man. They've been had us marked. Okay? Now, they're starting to put it to name. They already knew who the Great Millstone was. They knew who the apostles were. They know who the different prophets in the different states are. Now they put a name to it. Great millstone, man. Okay?
That ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulations 10 days.
That ye may be tried, your faith. And that 10 days can be 10 days, a month, 10 minutes, an hour. Whatever the Lord has set for us in that time, it's to try us, man. And not every brother is going to be thrown into a concentration camp. Not every brother is going to be grabbed up by Esau's foot patrol, man. Because the Lord said when the enemy comes, can you hold that? Get Isaiah 59:19. Because Esau, you got your agenda, you got your plan, hey, but the Lord got a bigger and better plan, okay? You ain't gonna just come up and get us and grab us up. Some of you will, but not everybody, man. Because the Lord's gonna give his men spiritual powers.
9:19.
Yeah. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 59, verse 19. So shall they fear the name of Yahweh from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun, when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord Yahweh shall lift up a standard against him.
That's right. So when the enemy come in like a flood, with his NATO troops, with his UN troops, with his US troops, with your FBI, all of these people, your tactical forces, the Lord said he's gonna lift up a standard.
What?
Can you read that again?
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 59, verse 19. So shall they fear the name of Yahweh from the west.
From the west, what is that? What is the west? Here in America, man. Because in the east, Yahweh was feared at one point. Till the so-called white man came up in the power. Trying to delete all the history books, or hide them at least, man. Okay?
And his glory from the rising of the sun,
which is in the east, man. Okay? Wait.
When the enemy shall come in like a flood.
When the enemy shall come in like a flood, which is all those different troops, whether they be Spetsnaz, whether they be NATO, whether they be US, whether they be China, when the enemy shall come in like a flood,
the Spirit of the Lord Yahweh shall lift up a standard against them.
The Spirit of the one you call God and Jesus is going to lift up a standard against you, man. You're not going to be able to take the Lord's anointing, man.
That's right.
You're not going to be able to take us in that day. Okay? You know, a lot of people, Becca, a lot of people, you see this song right here, right? You know that the one they call Jesus, the so-called black man, according to the Bible, right? You know that, sir? And he's not a, okay, now you got these false prophets telling you that God loves everybody and everything's going to be okay. But according to the scriptures, things are not going to be okay.
That's
if
right.
If you find yourself fearing the Heavenly Father and believing in His Son, Yahweh Shai, great tribulation is awaiting us, man. A great day of persecution, but there's hope. We're not going to be set up. We're going to be set up like, because we're sheep, fed to the slaughter. Here it is, we out here preaching the word of truth of Yahweh Shinah Bashai, and the only thing we got is faith, man. We ain't come out here with no carnal weapons. We ain't come out here with no army. Our army is in the spiritual realm, which is the angels, man.
That's right.
Which the chief general is Yahweh Shinah, man. Okay? We're waiting on him. We're waiting on him. So that when the Lord do, when that standard is set up, the Most High is gonna indulge, give us that spiritual power. Was that it on that?
My neighbor
is on the street. Isaiah 59, verse 20. And the Redeemer shall come to Zion, and unto them that turn from transgression in Jacob, saith Yahweh.
Oh, it's a meaty net. Go ahead and read it again.
And the Redeemer shall come to Zion.
The Redeemer, which is Yahweh Shai, shall come to Zion, to Zion, another name for Israel, which is the monument of the Lord. Go ahead.
And unto them that turn from transgression in Jacob.
And unto them that turn from transgression in who? Jacob, man. What is transgression? Sin. What is the sin? Transgression of the law. The elect. Lord willing, we're the hopeful members of that. We turn away from all of that, man. If you was in the world, you was committing adultery, you stopped that shit, man. You was in the world, you was a thief, you was a liar, murderer, a drug dealer, gangbanger. You was in the world being a nigga, you stopped that. Meaning you turned away from it and you turned to righteousness, man. You turned to the fear of the Lord. And Jacob, go ahead, read it again.
And the Redeemer shall come to Zion. And unto them that turn from transgression in Jacob, saith the Lord Yahweh.
Yep, and to them that turn away from transgression. And to them that turn away from transgression in Jacob, saith Yahweh. Now go to Isaiah 40.
The creator of the ends of the earth.
all of this beautiful order came out of chaos, so-called Big Bang, which is a lie. How about Shinya Rashad created all of this? Go ahead.
Satan not, neither is weary.
Yeah, he don't get tired, man. Neither is he weary. Go ahead.
There is no searching of his understanding.
You can't understand the Lord, man. The Lord got to be dealing with you for the understanding him, man. Go ahead.
He giveth power to the faint.
He giveth power to the faint. Go ahead.
And to them that have no might.
And to them that have no might. And we don't have no might down here for this thing. He giveth power to the faint and to them that have no might. We don't have no might down here. Can you look at that word might? We're broke down here, man. We're torn down as a people, man. As a nation, man. While all these other heathen nations, they got army, they got governments. We don't have that down here on this earth, man. Because we're in captivity, okay? We're in bondage. We're subject to our enemies, man. We're subject to our enemies, man. For the one of all things, man, okay? You jakes, you out here yelling, America this, America that. America don't love us, man. So it says that word for might is a Hebrew word. That word might is a Hebrew word. I won. Which is vigor, generative power, wealth, physical strength. Yeah, so we don't have none of that down here, man. We don't have real wealth. We don't have physical strength. But the Most High give that kind of power to the faint, man. Which is us, man. Wait, say it again.
Isaiah 40, verse 29. He giveth power to the faint and to them that have no might.
He increases strength. He gives them sloppy, brother. He gives power to the faint and them that have no might, them that have no physical strength, man. He gives power to us. Go ahead.
And to them that have no might,
yep.
He increases strength.
He increases our strength spiritually, and then he's going to do it physically. Go ahead.
Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall.
Yep.
But they that wait upon the Lord Yahweh shall renew their strength.
So we're waiting on the Lord, man. You see, like I was telling you, we were discussing right before we opened up here. You get a lot of these so-called Black, Hispanic, Native American women and men. They say they want their daughters to be with a godly man, right? Here it is, from being godly, man. But y'all look at us and y'all cuss us out, talk crap in your minds. These niggas are crazy. These niggas got Bibles in their hand. Here it is, we're giving you the. Through the spirit power of Yahweh Bashiach was shot, we're giving you the word of the Lord, man. We're showing faith. Just us being out here is a faith, it's just a faith move right here, bro. We're open to the elements. We can get killed any day. Any of our enemies, if they got a hair up there behind them, come take us out, man. You know? We're being ostracized. But this is a strong show of faith. So, okay, we're in the midst of our enemies. Tell them that America's gonna be destroyed. Tell them the white man he's a devil. Two-thirds of our people that they're wicked. We're in the mouth of the enemy. We're waiting on the Lord. We're not waiting on man. We're not trying to force the Lord's hand. We're waiting on Yahweh Bashiach was shot.
That's right.
He's gonna raise up that standard. So we're not afraid of jail. We're not afraid of being killed. We're not afraid of being ostracized. We're not afraid of being none of that. Because we know that our power is in Yahweh Bashiach was shot.
That's right.
He's going to give us the power to defend ourselves. He's going to defend us, man. Even when that spiritual power comes on us. So read it again.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verse 31. But they that wait upon the Lord Yahweh shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with their wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint.
Yeah, so that's the spiritual power gonna allow us to fly. It's gonna allow us to walk and not get tired. We're gonna run and not pass out. We're gonna run and not get tired, man. We're gonna gonna be able to do spiritualistic things, man. We're gonna be able to heal people, okay? We're gonna be able to run through tanks and like sliced bread, man.
That's
like
right.
A light through butter, okay? When Esau, because Esau got, he got all kinds of shit ready. And this dude got soldiers, secret soldiers serum. Okay, he got Iron Man suits. Okay, he got shit, they got shit they even show you. Like a lot of them troops down in South America, even in the North America, but chiefly in South America, they got armor where you can't pierce them. You can't pierce them with a gun, a knife, a punch don't hurt them. Bulletproof masks, bulletproof helmets, bulletproof chest shields and arm shields. All of that shit, man. So what can a regular man do against something like that? And that's just the minimum. So hey, we're trying to show our people, you black snakes, Native Americans, hey, we got hope, bro. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of death, because what is death but a sting? You got to die for this truth, so be it.
That's right.
We're going to do it. Because we know that if we die on this side, we just going to manifest them chariots with Yahweh Shai, man. By the time we get to the spirit world, Yahweh Shai putting on that armor. Hey, what's up? Shalom, Akhtar. Go ahead and get your armor together. It's right there. Get on this chariot. We on our way back. You see? We endure to the end. We endure all the harshness, all the tribulation. Guess what? Yahweh Shai going to give us that strength, that power, Betty. He going to be waiting for us, man.
That's right.
Ain't nobody afraid of Esau's army. Ain't nobody afraid of his police system. Ain't nobody afraid of none of that.
That's right.
Now my strong shine with his elect. And we're giving hope to the faint. Two-thirds of Israel, you faint right now, man. You just done. One-third of Israel, we're tired. The hopeful elect, we're tired. Weary. The scripture says, he shall wear out the saints. So the Lord's going to rejuvenate us. Okay?
Go ahead and read it again.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verse 31. But they that wait upon the Lord, Yahweh, shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles.
Yeah, we're going to be able to fly in that day, man. We're going to be able to do so much. You know what the scripture said? Yeah, man, we're going to mount up with wings, man. We're going to be able to fly, man. Okay? I know it's hard for you to believe that, because the so-called white man has deceived you so much. He's the only one that can be a superhero. He's the only one that can fly. They got this new movie, Infinity War, out. Okay? Most of the characters in there are Edomites, man. With mutant spiritual powers, man. And they make the bad guy, who's really the good guy, they make him seem all jacked up. Okay? And the good guy, you trying to uphold your system. Okay, here it is, the Avengers, they get jacked up. They got jacked up. And the other Avengers, and down there in criminals by their own country. Here it is, the white man, he got no spiritual power, but he got the power to make you a criminal, man. And these niggas had to scatter, man. You got to sell out, they signed the paperwork, they took the chip. Then you got the other ones that was like, no, we ain't gonna do it, but we just gonna still be out here saving people, man. Then they all gotta come together to save the world from Thanos, man. You see how kind of fucked up shit is that, man? You don't want nothing new. Yahweh Shai is coming to bring new, man. He gonna restore this earth to its glory, man.
That's right.
And it's gonna be a big calling of people, man. So the so-called white man got an agenda to kill 6.5 billion people, but we're the enemy. He got something called Agenda 21, but we're the enemy. He poisoned the food, the air, the water, but we're the enemy. You see what kind of hypocrisy that is, man?
That's right.
Go ahead and read it.
This is the book of John, chapter 14, verse 12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me,
he that believeth on me,
the works that I do shall he do also.
So you believe on Yahweh Shai, the one you can call Jesus. You're going to do the works that he did. What some of the works Yahweh Shai did? He raised people from the dead. Healed people of their sicknesses, their ailments. Cast out devils, demons off of people, man. Okay? Walked on water. Was able to disguise himself amongst the people, man. Those works that he did, we didn't get.
He that believeth on me.
You got to believe on Yahweh Shai, and also not just believe, but believe on him as it is written.
The works that I do shall he do also.
Yeah, we're going to do also.
And greater works.
And greater works, man.
Then. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father.
That's right, man. So Yahweh Shai is with the Father right now, man. But the Father's about to send him back. But before the Lord sent Yahweh was sending his son, Yahweh Shai, our Lord and Savior, back, guess what? This elect man, we're going to be able to do the things he did and more. It's a balance, man. We ain't just going to be kicking Esau in the ass, man. We're going to be healing our people, man. The elect of our people, man. The elect of Israel. Because you got a lot of us that's sick, that's lame, that's hurt. You know what I mean? Our people possessed with demons and shit. Hey, we're going to be able to cast that out, man. And what you think is going to happen when these people see us in the presence of the Lord, man? And that's when they're really going to start to wake up, man. And as soon as the signs of the day of the Lord's power, they shall be willing. Yeah, when the day of the Lord's power, you're going to be willing to hear the word, man. You're going to be willing to be with this thing, man.
This is the book of John, chapter 21, verse 25. And there are also many other things which Yahweh Shai did, the which, if they should be written, every one, I suppose that even the world itself cannot contain the books that should be written.
Yeah, so it's works that Yahweh Shai did that they can't even write. It'll take all the pages of every book on the earth, man.
That's right.
It still ain't enough, man. So imagine that. We're going to be able to do those works and greater. And greater, man. And greater. So we got a lot to look forward to if we endure to the end. That's why we pray to Yahweh Shai, keep his spirit on us, that we can endure to the end, man.
That's right.
Because the Lord's going to lift up the standard, man. He's not going to let us be swallowed up by the enemy, man. That's faith, man. Can you go to Hebrews 11 and 1? That's what we're going to read through that. Old Acts 14. We're going to read through, Hey, because this thing is about faith, man. This thing is about faith, man. And what is faith? To you brothers on a common board, man. What's faith? You need to be quick.
This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verse 1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for.
The substance of things hoped for. What are we hoping for, man? Salvation. What are we hoping for? To be saved. What are we hoping for? To see our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
What are we hoping for? Kingdom. What are we hoping for? A continuing city. What are we hoping for? To see our enemies destroyed.
That's right.
Okay?
The evidence of things not seen, for by it the elders obtained good report. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, and who's the word of Yahweh? Who's the word of Yahweh? Yahweh Shai, man.
So that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear.
Right, so see, the white man trying to make science the thing of, oh, this is how everything was created. There was a big explosion, and all this order came out of all the elements. He tried to be all intricate, man. But we know through faith, we can't see Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah with perfect eyes. You know what that said? We can't see him with these eyes, but we know through faith that he created everything, man. We can't see the Lord with these earthly eyes, but we know that all this order was framed by Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah. That's faith. Faith is the substance of things not seen, things hoped for.
That's right.
In 2000 Israel, you don't have no hope. Your hope is in the so-called white man. Oh, Trump's going to deliver us. Trump's going to make America great again, man. No, he's not. America was great because we were in slavery. America was great because the so-called white man destroyed our people and stole his land by way of the sword and oppressed the children of Israel. So why are you, and the scripture says, cursed is he that put his trust in men. Scripture also says, trust not in the God, trust not in the friend, nor in the God. He ain't supposed to trust in no man. He's a physical man. He's a lesser man. And you trusting in him. It's going to be your destruction.
This is the book of 2 Esdras, chapter 1, verse 37. I take to witness the grace of the people to come, whose little ones rejoice in gladness. And though they have not seen me with bodily eyes, yet in spirit, they believe the thing that I say.
Read it again.
2 Esdras, chapter 1, verse 37. I take to witness the grace of the people to come, whose little ones rejoice in gladness.
Yeah, we're rejoicing in gladness for the things to come, man. We're praying that Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah come speedily, man. We're praying that the Lord destroy this place speedily and deliver us, man.
And though they have not seen me with bodily eyes.
With these bodily eyes. We ain't seen the Lord with these bodily eyes, man. See, the so-called white man, he gotta see it to believe it, man. Show, he gotta carnally feel it and see it and touch it for him to believe it. That's why he goes about the earth, digging, finding all these antiquities, man. And then he pouring them and putting them in his boat somewhere, man. But we got faith. Children of Israel, the elect of Israel, we're children of faith. Can you read that again, brother?
And though they have not seen me with bodily eyes, yet in spirit they believe the thing that I say.
Yet in spirit. We ain't seen the Lord with these bodily eyes, but in our spirit, we believe these things that are said, man. Why do you think we out here, man? You think that your pastor and your preacher in the church, he believe in the Lord? He don't believe in the Lord. All he believe in is his belly.
That's right.
All he believe is in money, substance, material gain. And that's what all those churches are about in the world, man. Material gain. Supposing gain is godliness, man. But it's not. We haven't seen the Lord with these physical eyes, but we believe in the things that are said. through the spirit. And that's something that the so-called white man can't understand. Why they got in the spirit? How did this truth get out? Why they believe the way they believe? It don't make no sense. We use millions of dollars to hide it. We even took the sellouts of their people, and they still got it. That's because of the Lord, man.
The second book of Ezra, chapter 1, verse 37. And take to witness the grace of the people to come, whose little ones rejoice in gladness, and though they have not seen me with bodily eyes, yet in spirit, they believe the thing that I say.
And we're the little ones, man. We're the little ones, man. But we're rejoicing in gladness, man.
That's right.
That our time has come, man. That Yahweh should be our shackle to deliver us, man.
That's right.
We ain't gonna be in this captivity no more, man. The Lord gonna have mercy on us, man. And that's the spirit you're supposed to be in, man. You ain't supposed to be getting weak. You're supposed to be a man.
That's right.
This thing is about being a man.
That's right.
Hey, I need you to look up the scripture that says, show yourself to be men. This thing is about being a man. Huh? Tired of pussyfooting, man. You got our men out here all weak. Remember that? You're supposed to be having some nuts out here, man. That's a sign of faith, man. That's, we ain't even paying attention to the scoffers, man. Let them scoff, man. You make fun now. Hey, the scripture says, woe to him that's full now. For you shall, woe to him that is full. Woe to him that is laughing. Woe to him that laugh now. For you shall mourn and weep and howl, man.
Go ahead, bro. There's one in Job 2.
Go to 7 Kings 14. Get over here. We out here pouring our hearts out, man. Showing ourselves to be men. Like the Lord expect us to, man. Because two-thirds of Israel, the men of Israel, you're weak, man. You're insufferable, man. So the Lord's got to do away with you, man. Because your God is your belly. Your God is the devil, man. And unless your father is the devil, man.
This is the book of 1 Kings, chapter 2, verse 2.
God.
I go the way of all the earth. Be thou strong, therefore, and show thyself a man.
Yeah, I mean, gird yourself. Gird yourself to be men. Gird yourself.
Gird
yourself.
Amen.
That's right, man. Because all you people walking around depending on the fucking government, depending on Esau, on the white man that's in power, you afraid, man. You don't believe in nothing. You don't believe in yourself. You don't believe in nothing, man. You guys are fucking pitiful.
Yeah, man. Hey, this is Job 38 and 2. Job chapter 38. Job. Is it Job 38 and 3? Job 38 and 3. Matter of fact, start at Job 38 and 1. Job 38 and 1. Right, the brother Yaikwab, Yasha Allah, Luke 6:25. Woe unto you that are full, for ye shall hunger. Woe unto you that laugh now, for ye shall mourn and weep, man. And that's right, man. You people are poor, man. You people are poor, but you're going to be hungry, man. Especially when it's famine ahead, man. Woe to you that's laughing. You love laughing. Jake loves to laugh. Who was that walking by earlier? Heckling. Those are Israelites, man. Heckling, man. This, the gay dude in the back told him to shut up, man. He's walking, man. That would have been the best thing he could have done, man. Because all of that would have turned into weeping, man. Weeping and mourning and gnashing the teeth, man. Way to read.
This is the book of Job, chapter 38, verse 1. Then the Lord Yahweh answered Job out of the whirlwind and said, who is this that darkens counsel by words without knowledge? Gird up now thy loins like a man, for I will demand of thee, and answer thou me.
Yeah, gird up your loins like a man, okay? Because that's what the Most High expect us to do, man. That's what he's going to answer. He's going to want you to be a man. Selfie taking money phone to the air heaven. We smoking niggas, man. We're men of the Lord.
That's right.
We're men of distinction, of dignity.
This is the book of Ecclesiasticus, Sirach, chapter 2, verse 1. My son, if thou come to serve the Lord Yahweh, prepare thy soul for temptation.
Yeah, you gotta prepare to be tempted, man. You're gonna catch hell, man. You're gonna go through some things, man, that you ain't never been through before, man. But it's to make sure wisdom is trying you, to make sure that you're worthy of her, man. The Most High is building your faith up for the times to come.
Set thy heart aright.
Yeah, set your heart right. Get your mind right, man.
And constantly endure.
Constantly endure, man. Constantly endure hardships. Constantly endure the pain, the suffering, man. Constantly endure these curses, man. Because that's what we got to deal with down here. We got to deal with these curses, man. We got to deal with this affliction.
And make not haste in time of trouble.
You ain't supposed to make haste in the time of trouble, man. You got some Jake, they start catching a little bit of hell. They drop something. Oh, man, I'm good. I ain't a sister like you anymore. I'm good. Your woman leave you. You got hell. Your kids leave you. You might get booked. Yeah, you might get thrown in a prison. You get ostracized. People start calling you names. You don't want to deal with that. Hey, read it again.
Set that heart aright.
Get your mind right. You want to serve the Lord, you're going to have to get your mind right. They're not telling you that in these churches, man. They're telling you that everything's going to be all right. Everything's going to be okay. You're going to prosper when you come and serve Jesus. God loves everybody. You can do whatever you want. Just come back next Sunday, pay your tithes, and ask for forgiveness, and you're straight. Well, that ain't the truth.
And constantly endure.
You got to constantly endure.
And make not haste in time of trouble.
You can't make haste in a time of trouble, man. You can't drop the ball when you're cutting hell, man. Look, Esau is through, man. It's only 5 o'clock, you're broke, man. Esau is finished, man. Okay? Look at that shit, man. Done, man. Through, man. Fucking through, man. Get freedom, brother.
Cleave not unto him and depart not away, that thou mayest be increased, yeah, at the last end.
Cleave unto the Most High, don't depart. How do you cleave to the Most High? To this word. Every time you go through something, you need to be reflecting on this word. Whether it's good, bad, or indifferent, you need to be cleaving to this word.
That's right.
And Esau down the street staggering. And they staggering with a drink, but not with strong drink, and not with wine, man.
Book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 2, verse 3. Cleave unto him and depart not away, that thou mayest be increased at the last end.
Yeah, you hold on to this word, you're going to be increased at the last end. That's the bow, the faith.
Whatsoever is brought upon thee,
whatever is brought upon you, man,
take carefully, cheerfully.
Take it cheerfully, man.
And be.
I'm sorry, please.
Whatsoever is brought upon thee, take cheerfully and be patient when thou art changed to a low state.
So whatever is brought upon you, take it cheerfully. And be patient when you change to a lower state. When you come into this truth, you're going to be changed to a lower state. We ain't recognize the most of people. You see Jake walking up and down the street all day, every day. Every week we come out here, we see Israelites, whether they be confusion of faces or wrestling Israelites. That you know it's Israelites. They see us. They look at us like we're nothing. Me and the brother was talking about how in the world, you know, we got friends in the world. They might see us, and they don't even recognize us, man. They just keep walking. We're in the lowest state. But you come over to the champion. Oh, it's all right. The boys, this is going to happen. You might lose your work. You might lose your place. You might just be all jacked up, catching hell. Hey, the Lord said this is going to happen, man. But you're supposed to stay faithful. Keep coming down here. Keep doing the work. Keep having faith in Yahweh Bashi Yahweh Shah. Meditating on the scriptures, man. That's what you got to do. Jake, don't pray. You got to pray in this thing, man. All the time. Scripture says pray without ceasing. That's your number one tool, baby. So why not use it?
That's right. For coal is tried in the fire and acceptable men in the furnace of adversity.
Gold is tried in the fire, and acceptable men are tried through the furnace of
adversity.
Of adversity, man. And adversity means hard times, hardship, man. And the Lord ain't gonna just keep kicking your ass. He gonna go through some things and then bring you up out of it. You might get a break. He gonna go through some more stuff. It's levels through this thing, man. But it's all to build your faith up, man.
Believe in him, and he will help thee order thy way aright and trust in him.
Believe in him, he will help thee order your way aright and trust in him, man. So the Most High always gonna direct your steps to the right path, man. He ain't never gonna have you going off, man. He always gonna make you right, man. That's why you gotta trust in the Lord, man. Keep reading.
Ye that fear the Lord Yahweh, wait for his mercy and go not aside, lest he fall.
Yeah, wait for his mercy. Don't be hasteful in the spirit, man. Don't try to make something happen or try to push the Lord's hand. Okay? Can you read that again?
Ye that fear the Lord Yahweh, wait for his mercy.
Wait for the mercy of Yahweh Bashi Yahweh Shah. Again, that's why we're not telling nobody to move out carnal, man. Wait for his mercy. But even with that, we're still number enemy number one right now. Because we got the truth. And Esau don't want you to have the truth.
And go not aside, fall.
Yeah, you go aside, you're gonna fall, man. And we got examples of that, man. Jake get puffed up in the spirit, puffed up with knowledge. Then he falls off, but Jake just get loose, lack of faith. Which is, if you win this thing for a number of years and you fall out, that means you had no faith, man. You didn't believe, you were just in this thing. And we got a lot of actors in this thing, man. And this thing, it's not for hypocrites, man. You gotta be down with this thing or not. Hey, the Lord don't want, hey, double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
Right.
That's right.
Yeah.
You gotta dig in the truth, thinking in the truth, and then he's back in the world. Well, I'm in the truth Wednesday. Saturday, I'm in the truth. Monday, Friday, man, I'm in the world. Hey, you wavering, bro. You can't do three videos for a week. You got a problem with that? You got a problem with order? Hey, the Lord not dealing with that kind of dude, man. You either in this thing or you're out this thing. We'd rather be in this thing, man, because this is our covering. Once you lose that covering, you assed out, man.
That's right. Ye that fear the Heavenly Father, believe him.
Believe him.
And your reward should not fail.
Your reward's not going to fail, man. We're telling you, if you believe in the Lord, your reward's not going to fail. You soda-drinking niggas, man. Soda-drinking niggas, man. Hey, you don't believe in the Lord, man. You don't believe in the Lord. You believe in yourself. With your mouth, you say, oh, I believe. I'm with this, man. But your heart, your mind, is far from the Lord, man. You ain't following his laws and his commandments. You ain't got your faith in the Lord. You don't believe in his name. You're taking his name out of it. You're trying to delete the sign. Hey, man, you ain't, hey, man, a nigga like that, you got to go, bro.
That's right. Ye that fear the Heavenly Father, hope for good hope and for everlasting joy and mercy.
Ye that fear the Most High, Yahweh Shemeshah, hope for good and everlasting mercy. That's what we hoping for, man. Go ahead.
Look at the generations of old and see, did ever any trust in Yahweh, but Hashem Yahweh Shai, and was confounded?
Look at all the prophets, man. Look at the apostles and the elders, man. 30 years doing the same thing, grinding it out, elevating in the truth, growing in the faith, able to teach other men. Able to teach other men. You niggas gonna get put to death, man. Able to teach other men. Having faith. So much so that we believe in. See? They wasn't confounded. So how much more us, man? That's why the Lord said, hey, ye of all little faith, man.
That's right.
Because even the disciples in the early time, they were simple, man. You know what I mean? But they had to go through some things, and they grew in the faith and became apostles, man.
Or did any abide in his fear and was forsaken?
Yeah, if anybody that feared the Lord, was they ever forsaken? No. All you gotta do is look at Job. Look at the prophets, man. Look at Yahweh Shai, man. He wasn't forsaken. Even though when the Lord took his power from him, he felt that. He was like, oh, Lord, my Lord, why have you forsaken me? Why are you forsaken me? And the Lord didn't forsake me, he just had to go through that. And the servant is no greater than the master. So if our master went through that, then we're going to have to go through that, man. But guess what? We hold on to the faith, man. We're going to get through this thing, man.
That's right.
With flying colors, man. With flying colors, man. We're going to, hey, the scripture says the righteous are scared to be saved. But still, even in that, you're supposed to have faith, man. You got faith with the mustard seed, we can make a mountain disappear, man. Yeah, I wish I said that to her.
Or whom did he ever despise that called upon him?
Yeah, the Most High don't despise nobody that truly calls on him. If you truly believe in the Lord, you truly have faith in your heart, Rosh Hashanah, he's not going to despise you. He's not going to despise you, man. He's going to hear you, man. And we're walking witnesses to that, man. We pray to the Lord all the time, man. Plenty of stories how the Lord delivered us. The apostles and the elders, walking witnesses, man. Plenty of stories of how the Lord delivered them, man.
For the Lord, Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, is full of compassion and mercy, long-suffering and very pitiful, and forgiveth sins and saveth in time of affliction.
Hey, Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, saveth in time of affliction. We opened up with, you know, we're being afflicted right now, man. We're being labeled as a hate group. You see Esau shaking his head? But when it all comes to fruition, it's going to be the biggest, I told you, so long on earth, man. You had your warning. You had your warning. Now you're going to get your destruction. Can you read that again, bro?
For the Lord Yahweh is full of compassion and mercy.
Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai is full of compassion and mercy to the elect.
Long-suffering.
Long-suffering, I mean patient.
And very pitiful.
And very pitiful, uh-huh.
And forgiveth sins.
And forgiveth sins of the elect.
And save it in time of affliction.
And he's going to save his elect in a time of affliction, man. That ain't for everybody, man. That's not even for all of Israel. That, what we read right here, that mercy, saving in time of affliction, pitiful, merciful, that's only for the elect, man.
That's right.
For the men that truly believe in the Lord, man.
Woe be to the fearful heart.
Yeah, woe to you that's fearful of heart, man. You scared to come out here. You scared to push this blood. You scared to be recognized as a man of the Lord. You scared to make yourself a living sacrifice to the Yahweh Shemaah Shah? Woe to you, man.
That's right.
Meaning destruction to you, go ahead.
And faint hands and the sinner that goeth two ways.
Yeah, the faint hands, man. And the sinner that goeth two ways. When you halfway in the truth, you halfway out the truth. Yeah, nigga, you go two ways, you're going to be destroyed.
Woe unto him that is faint hearted.
Woe unto him that is faint hearted. Again, this is about the men of Israel. Woe to the men of Israel that is faint of heart, man.
For he believeth not, therefore shall he not be defended.
Yeah, you don't believe in the Lord, you're not going to be defended in that day, man. You're not going to be defended in that day. You're going to be swallowed up. That movie, Don't Be Amazed by Drinking and Juice in the Hut. Hey, if you can't swim,
overcome at that.
I'm a truth. You were a truth. You were a truth. You were a truth. people that asked the homicide at. There's people that asked the apostles that, man. Hey, pray for me, man. And that should light your spirit up, bro. That lights your spirit up, man. How many of y'all people just asking for prayer, man? You're supposed to ask for that, man. That's faith, man.
That's right.
That's faith. He don't know us, man. But the spirit is lighting to us, man. That was a Kedite.
Ecclesiasticus?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this is the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 2, verse 14. Woe unto you that have lost patience, and what will ye do when the Lord Yahweh shall visit you?
Yeah, what you gonna do, man? All you dudes that was once with this truth, but you fell off, claim to go do your own thing, and then you twist the doctrine up, try to make yourself sound deep. What you gonna do when the Lord visits you, man? You gonna try to call on the Lord, but he's not gonna hear you.
That's right.
You gonna try to ask the Lord for assistance, but he's not gonna hear you. You jakes out here, you had more than enough opportunity to hear this word. But you was like, fuck them niggas. Them niggas are crazy. They're not ordained by the white man. They didn't go to Trinity Baptist College. They don't have a doctoral in reverend shit. So who the hell are they?
That's right. Like, they want people to be saints. And what does the fucking the Vatican do to make somebody saint? You gotta pay like 500,000 euros to be titled a saint.
Where
in the scriptures does it say that, man? But you people want to believe all of those fucking churches that are fucking lying to you. But hey, the Most High wants it like that.
Hey,
he needs all of you to fucking die.
The Lord
you're
said
you're made
he,
in vain.
It's lucky, brother. The Lord said he gonna give him stronger moves that he should believe a lie. You believe that lie, man.
That's right.
You can't pay your way into salvation. Hey, you gotta get, in order to get something, you gotta give something, man. 2/3 of Israel, you don't even wanna give your life, man. Which is not even yours.
That's right.
You scared to die. But you'll die in wickedness. You'll just be a nigga and just get shot up in the head. You niggas walk around the hood. Oh, I shot a bunch of niggas. I killed a bunch of niggas. I'm a murderer. I'm a nits. You relish in wickedness, man. You gonna die in your unfaithfulness, nigga.
That's right.
Jakes that want to be Muslims, you're going to die in that shit, man. Because the Lord gave you up to that, man. And you believe a lie. You really believe the Lord is dealing with you, man. Oh, I believe in my Lord. My Islam. Hey, you niggas is done, man. All them religions of the world, they just validate your wickedness, man. You can be a nigga and be a Muslim. Ain't nothing but a jailhouse religion. You be a nigga and be a Christian. Ain't nothing but a jailhouse religion. A slavery, plantation, Christianity.
Right. They that fear the Most High will not disobey his word.
If you fear the Most High, you will not disobey his word, man. If you truly fear them, man. The Lord said, go ye out in the highways and hedges. That was a commandment. Preach to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. That is a commandment. Why you ain't out here, man? Hey, every corner in USA, in the ghetto USA, all over the earth should have Israelite men standing up preaching this word, man.
That's right.
Every corner, man. Wherever the Israelites are at on the earth, you should be standing up if you're an Israelite man. But that's because you disobey the Lord's word.
And they that love him will keep his ways.
They that love him will keep his ways. It's the commandments, man. Hey, again, this thing is about being a man.
Was that in the right?
Go to 2 Timothy 2:1. Hey, this thing's about being a man. Hey, man, because see, you dudes y'all here, you're fake for a woman, man. But hey, these women, they gonna follow us in a day of trouble, man. They gonna be looking for men like the apostles and the elders and the brothers on down that's sincerely with this thing, man. They gonna be looking for a man of the Lord, plain and simple. A bunch of niggas are crackers, man. Niggas. Second Timothy, it should be Second Timothy. Yep, Second Timothy 2:1.
This is the book of Second Timothy, chapter 2, verse 1. Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Yahushua HaMashiach.
This is constantly encouragement, man. This is Paul encouraging Timothy, and he's encouraging us, man. Be strong in the faith of Yahushua HaMashiach.
And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses.
And we're witnesses, man. Lord willing, we pray to your light, man. We walk with your house, God. Elder Yashuwama said, man, you gotta look at it like, hey, man, I was there. You gotta look at it like, I was there. I saw your house, God. Those people, man. Your house, God, healed me. You gotta look at it like that, man.
Spiritually, he did.
Because he did. And we're witnesses, man. Read it again.
Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Yahushua HaMashiach, and the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men, who shall be able to teach others also.
That's the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, man. That's the apostles of Heart, that's the apostles of Akar, that's the apostles of Ramla, that's the apostles of Bar, Elder Sakharan, Elder Ainap, Elder Sakadak. Elder Tazayawan. Who else we got? Elder Mwatasa. Elder Yashawamba. Elder Ariyala. Huh? The brother priest, Yarza Young. Okay? All the priests. The priest, Amawan Gabar. The priest Gabar Rakar. I'm just naming a few, bro. Those men, us, but chiefly the apostles and the elders, man. Read that verse again, brother.
And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men.
Faithful men, commit it to faithful men.
Who shall be able to teach others also.
Showing you that you can't learn this thing on your own, man. You can't be this thing for a couple of years, and then you just jump up. Oh, the Lord's dealing with so many feet now. Oh, I got a revelation to break down. No, man. You had to learn this from some men. You learned the name of Yahweh Yahushua from the apostles and the elders. The Lashiwan Kadash from the apostles and the elders. We all did this, man. We're witnesses, man. And the brothers that learn from us.
That's right.
You know what I mean? We get brothers that learn from us, man. They can't just come up in there and think like, oh, I know what I'm talking about. No, man. You had to learn this from somebody, man.
Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Yahushua HaMashiach.
If you a soldier, you won't be a soldier, man. You brothers that been in the military before, man, you know what it's like, man. It's a solitary thing. If you want to be a good soldier for Yahushua, you gotta endure hardness. Hey, being a soldier is not easy, man. Ain't nothing easy about being a soldier, man. Long deployments, separated from your family, sacrificing your life, and other borders of the world. Hey, we doing that. We got family members on the mainland, but we're here. We're here, sacrificing our lives. We got family here. We got children, we got wives, we got jobs. We sacrificing all that to endure hardness as a good soldier of Yahweh HaMashiach, man. And being a soldier is not saying I'm a soldier. It's not wearing a t-shirt, I'm a soldier. Right. No, you're not. Right. You ain't sacrificing your life for your high boss, you was shot, but he sacrificed his life for us, then you ain't a soldier.
That's right.
You can't take orders. You can't take orders, whether you agree with them or not. You ain't a soldier. You can't sacrifice your measly ass life. You ain't a soldier, man.
That's right.
You ain't enduring hardness, man. You can't take the hell that comes with being a soldier. You ain't a soldier, bro. Read it again.
Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Yahushua HaMashiach.
So coming to be a soldier of Yahushua HaMashiach, you gotta be a soldier, man. You gotta endure that hardness, man. And this truth gonna make you hard.
No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life.
Right. If you're at war, you're not worried about what's going on back in the mainland. You ain't worried about your dead child or your mother or your woman, who she's laying up with. And you trying to live.
That's right.
We're ducking bullets and we're ducking demons. You know what I'm saying? We're trying to get out the way. We're praying, putting our shield up, watching our 12 and 6, watching our 2 and 3. You know what I'm saying? We're too busy worried about the war to be worried about the things of this world. Can you please be there again, brother?
No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life.
Yeah, if we war, we ain't entangling ourselves with the things of this life, man. We ain't worried about trying to get rich. We ain't worried about trying to own a house for 30 or 60 years. Hey, we're waiting on the Lord to come back.
That's right.
We're hasting for the day.
That he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier.
Hey, yeah, he may please him that chosen him to be a soldier, man. Hey, scripture says, many have come, few have chosen. You know anything about this? Hey, you're gonna be destroyed, man.
Hopefully.
Yeah, hopefully, man. That's Esau, man. They're trying to help him out. He got one of our women with him, but that's okay. You can have her. You got one of our women with you. Out of our nation. What's your woman's nationality?
You really want to fucking do this?
What's your woman's nationality? She looked like one of us. She looked like one of us. I ain't your boy, motherfucker. I put my foot in your fucking ass. I shut that fucking airlock to two feet, bitch. Don't play with me. And we gonna take your woman. And we gonna take your woman, you piece of shit. Keep on reading, man. Hey, y'all think it's a game out here, man. Again, we're not your average everyday, weed-smoking, homosexual, effeminate niggas, man.
That's right.
We are Israelite men.
That's right.
And you fuck with one of us, you gonna get destroyed. Read.
And every man also strive for masteries, yet he not ground except he strive lawfully.
Hey, read it again. Hey, we're trying to be peace with the dude, you know what I mean? Ask him questions. He walked by being a sarcastic demon. And then we said he got one of our women with him, but she looked like a Latin woman, huh? She ain't like no Edomite.
That's right.
She, you know, our women, they like the white men, especially the Latin women, man. But she gonna get her mind right. She gonna be washed with the blood of Yahweh by Shabbatai. She gonna be all right in the kingdom. He gonna be a slave, man. Read.
This is the book of 2 Timothy. Chapter 2, verse 1. Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace.
Be strong, man. You and this truth, brother, be strong, man. We have to enter this thing, man. And it's evident. It's clear as day. It's clear as day. Hey, the Lord is coming back sooner than you think.
That's right.
Prophecies are happening. It's a year of prophecy, isn't it?
That's right.
So that means prophecy is happening. Keep reading, brother.
In the grace that is in Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, and the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others.
That's the apostle and elder, great millstone, keep reading.
Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of his life.
Yeah, no man at war entangleth himself with the affairs of his life, man. We ain't worried about these bitches. We ain't worried about Esau. We ain't worried about no house, no job, no women, no children. We got this worried about, man. Hey, everything else will be taken care of for us if we endure hardness. So we can't entangle ourselves with the things of this world, man.
That he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier.
We trying to please you. How about Shin Yahweh Shai, who has chosen us to be a soldier, man?
That's right.
Hey, we're the ground force, man. We're the infantry, man. We're the grunts. And we got the Air Force, the chariots, the angels. We got a general that's willing to fight. That's Yahweh Shai. Okay? He got generals under him. Michael the Archangel. Okay? One of them. We got generals down here. The Pops and the Elders. And we're the ground force, man.
That's right.
We're the ground force, man. And we got the Navy, Leviathan. You know what I'm saying? The fish of the sea. Chief of Leviathan. He's the head of all of that down there. Hey, well, you got the angels, our brothers, man. They're standing around us right as we speak, man. That's why our people talk shit and they just walk up the block, man. You've been in things for a while, man. You don't get too razzle-dazzled by that shit, man. Because we know they're not going to do nothing, man. We know it, man. You try to flex for your bitch, man. You'll get swallowed up in front of your woman. She'll be picking you up off the street, man. We'll pack our shit up and go home. And crazy, how about she not return the whole way?
That's right.
We're the ground force, man. This is the army, man. Hey, can you hold that? Make Esau scared, man. I'm gonna be your boy for too much longer, man.
Yep. Verse 9.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 37, verse 9. Then said he unto me, prophesy unto the wind.
Hey, that's what we're doing too, man. Hey, cuz look, ain't a lot of people here. The biggest thing people say is, hey, nobody's listening to you guys. You're not important. Nobody's worried about you. You know what I'm saying? But hey, we're prophesying to the wind.
Prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, thus saith Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon this land. That they might live, that they may live.
That's word. Hey, we're speaking to the bride home, man. The elected bride home, man. Live and you have a question that was shot, man. Power, bro.
So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army.
That's right. So we are this roar, we live, man. Oh shit, we're Israelites, man. The sinews and the spirit of the Lord is on us now. We're reading. We're breaking the word down. We're living. And now we're an exceeding great army. We're standing on our feet. We're not sitting down. We're standing on our feet, an exceedingly great army. We might be two men, but we're an exceeding great army behind the Lord, man. We're an exceeding great army, man. That's okay. We have people listening to us. Yeah, we do. We're live right now. All on the YouTube. We're live on YouTube. Yeah, we're live on YouTube. Thank you. Yeah. And they're going to experience God quick, soon. They're going to experience the wrath of the Lord. Okay. Absolutely. You're absolutely right, man. All right. Have a great day, man. All right. Hey, man. That's about us, man. We laying on hands, man.
Hands, man.
All right. They laying on hands, man. Hey, but if it happened, you put your hands on us. You touch one of us, and it won't get touched too. I went to Tupac's head, touch one of mine. I'll make sure everything that I touch one of mine. I'll make sure, the first to bomb on your ass, man.
That's
right. Those are going to be the first to bomb on your ass.
We're going to cut you first, man, spiritually, so that you could be healed.
That's right, man. Yeah. We got to cut you, man. And we were cut. We got cut.
That's
we came
right.
out. We was like, oh, shit. That's me.
That's right.
I was being a nigga in the world. I ain't know no better, man. I was just going off and shit. But I was cut to the heart.
That's
and
right.
The Lord healed me. My brother right here, he was cut. Being a nigga in the world, man. Being a stick in the world, and he got cut, and then the Lord held him up. And he believed, man.
That's right.
Now we out here. An exceeding great army. Again, it seems like there's two of us here.
Right.
We got brothers all across the world, man. We got brothers that ain't even woke up yet, man. All across the world, even out here. And we got the spiritual angels, man. We an exceeding great army. See, it's funny to those that it ain't got nothing to do with, man. We know that this ain't funny, man. We know that this ain't this world, man.
That's right. So I prophesied as he commanded me.
Prophesied as he commanded me.
And the breath came into them.
And the breath, the word, spirit of Yahweh Shalom came into them,
and they lived,
and we lived, we're still living,
and stood upon their feet,
stood
an
upon
exceeding
their feet,
great army.
An exceeding great army, man. Show you that we're military, man. Hey, this is spiritual military over here, man.
That's right.
Okay? Shalom to the brothers on the common point again, too.
Then he said unto me, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel.
These bones are the whole house of Israel. Not Edom, not Moab, not Ammon, not Japheth. Israel.
Behold, they say, our bones are dry and our hope is lost.
Yep.
We are cut off of our parts.
Yep.
Therefore prophesy and say unto them, thus saith Yahweh power.
You guys got a question? Muslims, man. That's why you niggas get bombed to hell, man.
That's right.
And the Lord ain't dealing, Allah don't exist. Muhammad was a fraud. Hey, Muhammad was no prophet. All the prophets come out of Israel, man.
That's right.
I'm talking about he was the last prophet. This nigga couldn't read, write. He was a pedophile, a homosexual, a deviant.
That's right.
And number one, he was a heathen. He was a fucking heathen. Hey, the Lord ain't dealing with no fucking heathen.
That's right.
Hey, this ain't about being a, this ain't, hey, Islam is a fraudulent religion, man. It's a transsexual God. But Allah is a transsexual God, man. He got a penis and a vagina, man. That's why they walk around that Kaaba, that black stone, with a vagina in a corner of it, man. And they put their head in it and they kiss it, man. Where's Allah for you Muslims out there getting bombed to hell? Islam is nothing but a jailhouse religion, man.
That's right.
Set up the food of simple, man. By the Catholic Church, man, of all things. Why in your own book it say the children of the Lord are the Israelites, man?
That's
it don't
right.
say it's the Muslims. It don't say it's the Arabs. Hey, man, nobody's dealing with Islam around here, man. Now you can flush that shit down the toilet, man.
Then he said unto me, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. Behold, they say, our bones are dry and our hope is lost. We are cut off of our parts. Therefore, prophesy and say unto them, thus saith Yahweh power, behold, O my people, I will open your graves and yes. cause you to come up out of your graves.
And our people are dead, man. They're in a dead state, man. But now when they come back to the Lord, we're living now, man.
That's right.
We're living in Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, man. We ain't dead, we ain't naked. We ain't naked. We got our heritage. We got our God. We got
right.
our laws, our statutes, commandments, our constitution. That's the constitution right here, man. You got laws, statutes, commandments. You can't break them. You can't go behind them. They stand forever. We got our land. We know our land. We gonna get it back. We got a king. We got a monarch. We got a monarch, bro. Yahweh Shai, King David.
That's right.
We want to be a nation of kings and priests. We got a whole setup. We got a governing body, the elect.
Oh, my people, I will open your graves and cause you to come up out of your graves.
And how does he cause you to come up? By his word, man.
And bring you into the land of Israel.
And he's going to bring us, he's going to bring us to the land of Israel. Not a double declaration. Not a decree by Britain, but Yahweh Shalom Shah is gonna bring us into that land, man.
That's right.
All 12 tribes of Israel. Say it with me. All 12 tribes of Israel, man. Not just a so-called Jew, man. All 12 tribes are gonna be in that land. All 12 tribes are gonna be in that land. Who's going to do it? Yahweh Shai. Who's going to do it? Yahweh Shai.
That's right. And ye shall know that I am the Lord Yahweh, when I have opened your graves, O my people, and brought you up out of your graves.
Yeah, and that's how we know that the Lord is the Lord, man. Because only the Lord can do this, man. This is a miraculous thing right here, bro. Hey, this is a spiritual thing that's happening right here, bro. An exceeding great army of men just standing out here for the Lord, man. Hey, and since we're talking about that, we're going to read about the reward. Was that hit on that screen? That verse right there?
There's another one.
No. We got to read it.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Go ahead. You going to read it?
No.
Okay, go to 2 Ezra chapter 2, starting at verse 40.
The book of 2 Ezra, chapter 2, verse 40.
Yeah,
we'll start from 40. 2 Ezra, chapter 2, verse 40. Take thy number, O Zion, and shut up those of thine that are clothed with white.
Yeah, that's that righteousness, man.
Which has fulfilled the law of the Lord.
Yep.
The number of thy children, whom thou longest for, is fulfilled. Beseech the power of the Lord Yahweh, that thy people, which have been called from the beginning, may be hallowed.
Yeah, which is the elect of Israel.
I, Esdras, saw upon the Mount Zion a great people, who I could not number, and they all praised Yahweh with songs.
That's the mixed multitude spoken about in Revelation 7 and 9. The mixed multitude of Israelites out of all corners of the earth, okay?
And in the midst of them, there was a young man of a high stature, taller than all the rest.
That's Yahawashah. That's Yahawashah. That's Yahawashah, okay? Because he's only, what, 33 years old when he went up to the spirit world? Yeah, young man. Yahawashah, young man. Even though he's the firstborn, hey, he's young, man. He's in his angelic form. He's young.
And upon every one of their heads, he set crowns.
So Yahawashah himself are going to set crowns on the heads of the elect of the 144,000. How wonderful is that, brothers? How wonderful is that, man? We're looking forward to that day. Hopefully, we're part of the elect. The hopeful elect. We're looking forward to that, brother.
And was more exalted, which I marveled at greatly.
Yep.
So
he's more exalted, and he's worthy to praise, man.
That's right.
Why? For what he did, man. He died on the cross for the elect of Israel, man. And was risen up for the elect of Israel, man.
That's right.
He took a beating for us, man. And the scripture says, no greater love than he that will sacrifice his life for his friends, man. Which is his brothers, man. Right. And we're his brothers, man. Go ahead.
So I asked the angel and said, sir, what are these? He answered and said unto me, these be they that have put off the mortal clothing and put on immortal.
Yeah, we put off the mortal clothing because when we get into the spirit, when we get into the flesh, we're going to put on that immortal clothing, man. That immortal flesh, man. And really, we put off the mortal, which is the way of this world, and put on the immortal, which is the flesh.
And have confessed the name of Yahweh, what Yahawashah, now are they crowned and receive palms.
So we confess the name of Yahweh by Shem Yahawashah, and that's what we're doing. We're confessing it to the world, man.
That's right.
And we're going to receive crowns and palms, which is a symbol of peace. Go ahead.
Then said I unto the angel, what young person is it that crowneth them and giveth them psalms and palms in their hands? So he answered and said unto me, it is the son of Yahweh.
That's Yahawashah.
Whom they have confessed in the world.
And we confess in the world, that's right.
Then began I greatly to commend them that stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord Yahweh by Hashem Yahawashah.
And that's what we're doing, man. We're standing stiffly, man. We're not being taken away, man. We're not being shaken. We're standing stiffly for Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, for the name of Yahweh and Yahushua. So there's a reward behind this, man.
That's right.
It's the greatest reward ever, man. We see fine-ass women, they're going to be our wives, man. Okay? We see lands, they're going to be ours, man. This earth is going to be us.
That's right.
We're going to inherit it, the kingdom of heaven with Yahweh Shai himself, man. Hey, he ain't stingy. Yahweh Shai, he's sharing it with his boys, man.
That's right.
Hey, that's a real friend, bro. You see how they get signed in with them, with their day ones with them and shit? Hey, we Yahweh Shai's day ones, man.
That's right.
And there's a reward for standing simple for him, man. Ain't nobody else doing it.
Then the angel said unto me, go thy way and tell my people what manner of things and how great wonders of the Lord Yahweh, thy power, thou hast seen.
Yeah, and that's what I just did, man. You go to jail, man. Hey, there's a reward behind this, brother. You should be happy, man. You should be excited. Hey, man, there's a reward behind us enduring to the end, man. There's a reward. There's a just reward for the elect of Israel, man. And we want that. This is what we want, man.
That's right.
We want that interrupted ground, man. We want salvation, man. Hey, we want Yahweh Shai to remember our names, man.
That's right.
We ain't worried about these people in the world. We worried about Yahweh Shai, man. Because we're going with them for the elect. We're going to inherit the kingdom of heaven, man. And we endure to the end. Let's read Revelation 7 and 1. We're going to look for a stop at 9. 1 through 9.
7 and 1?
Yes, sir.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 7, verse 1. And there came one of the angels, and there came one of the seven angels, which had the seven veils, and talked with me, saying unto me, come hither, I will show unto thee the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters.
It's going to be the destruction of America, man. Ultimately, the destruction of America. Okay?
With whom the kings of the earth have committed fornications.
Seven.
The book of Revelation, chapter 7 and 1.
Yep.
And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth.
Yeah, so those four winds are the north, west, south, east, destruction.
That the wind should not blow on the earth.
That the wind should not blow on the earth, that destroying wind, that nuclear destroying wind. Go ahead, brother.
Nor on the sea, nor on any tree.
Nor on the sea, or any tree. And we know that sea is a people. So it's a nation. The sea is a nation, okay?
And I saw another angel ascending from the east.
And he saw another angel ascending from the east. Go ahead, brother.
Having the seal of the living power.
Having the seal of the living power, which is his name. Okay? Go ahead, brother.
And he cried with a loud voice.
He cried with a loud voice.
To the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea.
That's right.
Saying, hurt not the earth,
hurt
neither the sea.
Hurt not the earth, neither the sea. Go ahead.
Nor the trees. So we have sealed the servants of our power in their foreheads.
Right.
And I heard a number, and I heard the number of them which are sealed. And there were sealed 144,000.
So this destruction is not going to happen until all 144,000 are sealed. Like Apostle Hart said, he believes that they've been sealed, man. Hey, because this destruction is coming.
That's right.
And the only one that's going to be protected in that day to have that seal, that the wild that's spoken about in Ezekiel 9 and 4, is the elect. The elect of Israel.
And there was sealed in 144,000 of all the tribes of the children of Israel.
Of all the tribes of the children of Israel. Not all the tribes of the world. No. Is everybody an Israelite? No. Israel is just one nation out of 18 nations that's on the earth, but it's the top nation, man. So 12,000 men, let me get the board. 12,000 men, can you be good again, brother?
And there were sealed in 144,000.
144,000.
Of all the tribes of the children of Israel.
Of all the tribes of the children of Israel, man. Go ahead. Hold on.
Of the tribe of Judah.
Of the tribe of Judah, which is the so-called Negro, so-called African-American, you're the tribe of Judah, 12 months, go ahead.
We're sealed 12,000.
We're sealed 12,000. These are 12,000 prophets out of the tribe of Judah.
Of the tribe of Reuben.
The tribe of Reuben, which would be these so-called Seminole Indians.
12,000.
They're sealed 12,000.
Of the tribe of Gad.
Of the tribe of Gad, which would be so-called Native Americans. Oh. We had a Gadite come up here earlier. Right. So, and what do you see, brother? The sign, right?
Yep.
You saw that sign, man. And it's showing you the importance of this sign right here, bro.
That's right.
When he stopped, did he not saw the sign? He said, hey, what you got done? I'm a Gadite. I'm a Native American. I'm a Gad. Gad means truth, right? Yes. Yes, it does. Go ahead, brother.
Of the tribe of Asher.
Of the tribe of Asher, which means so-called Peruvians, Uruguayans.
We're sealed 12,000.
12,000 men out of y'all coming.
Of the tribe of Naphtali.
Of the tribe of Naphtali, which would be so-called Argentinians, the Chileans.
We're sealed 12,000.
12,000 prophets coming out of y'all.
Of the tribe of Manasseh.
The so-called Cubans. 12,000 coming out of y'all.
Of the tribe of Simeon.
Of the tribe of Simeon, the so-called Dominicans. 12,000 prophets coming out of you.
Of the tribe of Levi.
Of the tribe of Levi, you so-called Haitians. 12,000 coming out of you.
Of the tribe of Issachar.
You so-called Mexicans. 12,000 coming out of you.
And of the tribe of Zebulun.
Zebulun would be the so-called Guatemalans and Panamanians. 12,000 men, prophets, are coming out of you.
Of the tribe of Joseph.
Which is Ephraim, the so-called Puerto Ricans. 12,000 men, prophets, are coming out of you.
Of the tribe of Benjamin.
You so-called West Indians, Jamaicans, Trinidadians, Barbadians. 12,000 men, prophets, are coming out of you.
After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude.
And after that, a great multitude, you notice the tribe of Dan wasn't mentioned. Because Dan was assimilated into the tribes of Israel, man. Read that again, verse 9.
After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude.
A great multitude.
Which no man could number.
No man could number.
Of all nations.
Of all nations.
And kindreds.
And kindreds.
And people and tongues.
And people and tongues. Because Israel was scattered amongst the four corners of the earth and all nations of the earth, man. So these are the Israelite foreigners, man. These are not everybody from different nations. These are the Israelite foreigners.
Stood before the throne.
Stood before the throne.
And before the Lamb.
And before the Lamb, which is Jehoshaphat.
Clothed with white robes.
Which is the righteousness.
And palms in their hands.
And palms in their hands. A symbol of peace. Okay? So we're talking about.
And cried with a loud voice, saying, salvation to our power, which sitteth upon the throne and unto the Lamb.
Salvation to our power, which is the power of salvation, man. That's Jehoshaphat, man.
That's right.
That's Jehoshaphat, man. And he's the power of the children of Israel, man. What's so hard to understand about that? And we know that means spoken to are the children of Israel, man. Spoken about in Exodus chapter 2 and Revelation 7:9. Showing you that the Bible and the apocryphal are, hey, they're spiritually inspired, man. Okay? Let's go to Revelation 5:1.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 5:1. And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the backside sealed with seven seals.
Yeah, that's the Bible, man. This is that little book that was sealed, written.
And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the back side sealed with seven seals.
That's his Bible. That's his book right here. At one point it was sealed. We didn't know. We couldn't open it, man. And the 2/3 of Israel is still sealed.
And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, who is worthy to open the book?
Who is worthy to open a book?
And to lose the seals thereof?
That's right.
And no man in heaven, nor on earth, neither under the earth.
So yeah, so like these reverends, these pastors, they can't get this word because it's not given to them. That's why you ask a pastor, hey man, what's the, you ask a pastor, hey, can you break down Revelation? Oh, that book is sealed. Hey, can you tell me what Daniel 12 means? Oh, that's sealed. Nobody got that. Jesus is God for everybody. Give me your money. You know what I'm saying? Because it's sealed to them, man. But go ahead. So at a time, it was at one point in time, what's up, bro? At one point in time, no man could get the true understanding of this book.
Neither under the earth was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. And I wept much because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. And one of the elders said unto me, weep not, behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah,
which is Yahawashai, not Haile Selassie, man. Yahawashai, the one who you hear me call Jesus Christ. His name is Yahawashai. Go ahead, brother.
The root of David hath prevailed to open the book and to lose the seven seals thereof.
See, the root of David. He opened it. Once he went to the spirit world, baby, he opened it, man. Adam was given. Go ahead.
And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four beasts and in the midst of the elders stood a lamb as it had been slain.
That's your house shot.
Having seven horns and seven eyes.
Right. Which is the seven churches. Good.
Which are the seven spirits of Yahweh.
That's right.
Sent forth into all the earth. And he came and took the book out of the right hand of him that sat upon the throne. And when he had taken the book, the four beasts and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, having every one of them harps and golden vials full of odors, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sung a new song, saying, thou art worthy to take the book. Revelation chapter 5:8. And when he had taken the book.
No picture, man.
And when he had taken the book, the four beasts and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, having every one of them harps and golden vials full of odors, which are the prayers of the saints.
Now who are the saints, man? The Israelites. Hold that, go to Psalms
1:48:13. Let them praise the name of Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, for his name alone is excellent. His glory is above the earth and heaven.
Right.
He also exalted the horn of his people, the praise of all his saints, even of the children of Israel.
So the Israelites are the saints, man.
A people near unto him, praise ye the Lord Yahweh, for Hashem Yahweh Shai.
So we are the saints of the Most High, man. Those are the saints written about in Revelation 7 and 9. Those are the saints written about in 2 Exodus 2, 41 down. Those are the saints, man. We are the saints, man. The Israelites, man.
That's
everybody
right.
Everybody else be a saint. These Catholic churches, you have to say they're paying $500,000 to be a saint. You're not no saint of the Most High. You're a saint of Satan. Only, you have to be an Israelite to be a saint. Okay? That was it.
Revelations chapter 5, verse 9. And they sung a new song, saying, Thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seals thereof, for thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to power by thy blood.
Yeah, the Most High, he said, his son, Yahweh Shai, to redeem us, the children of Israel, man. Hey, that's St. Matthew 1 and 21.
Book of Acts, chapter 5, verse 29. Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, We ought to obey Yahweh rather than men. The power of our fathers raised up Yahweh Shai, whom he slew and hung on a tree. Him has Yahweh exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, but to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins.
But to give repentance to Israel and the forgiveness of sins, man. So repentance is only for Israel. Forgiveness of sins is only for Israel. Salvation is only for who?
For Israel.
For Israel, man. See?
It's the book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 1. I say the truth, in Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, I lie not. My conscience also bear me witness in the Holy Ghost that I have great heaviness and continual sorrow in my heart. For I could wish that myself were accursed from Yahweh Shai, for my brethren my kinsmen according to the flesh.
According to the flesh? So you gotta be an Israelite, man.
Who are Israelites, to whom pertaineth the adoption and the glory and the covenants and the giving of the law and the service of Yahweh and the promises.
Yep. So the giving of the law was given to who? The Israelites. The promise was given to who? Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Israel, which went down to his 12 sons, the Israelites. Go ahead.
Who are the fathers and of whom, as concerning the flesh, Yahweh Shai came.
Whose are the fathers and of whom concerning the flesh Yahweh Shai came? So Yahweh Shai only came for the Israelites, man.
That's right.
What's so hard to understand about that, man? We're the saints, man. We're the saints. But nobody ever argued with the so-called Israeli over there. They don't argue about it. They really assume that he's the Lord, that they're the Lord's people. But look how they're acting, man. They ain't even under the curses. Look how they're acting, man. They ain't the Lord's people, man. The Lord didn't die and raise on the cross for them, man. He didn't sacrifice his life, give his life up for them. He gave his life up for the elect of Israel, man.
That's right.
What's so hard to understand about that, man?
Who is sober all? Who is sober all? The Most High blessed forever.
Tawab, man. So that was it, man. Okay? You see in the back of us, man, finally is set in great dignity, man. You got hundreds of people sitting on the corner watching niggas break dance and contort their bodies, man. But nobody's standing here listening to the word of Yahweh Shimei HaVashai, man. But when all hell breaks loose, then you won't get it. Can you get a girly? Yeah, because when all hell breaks loose, that's when y'all, you black Hispanics, Native Americans, you won't want to listen to the truth yet, man. And don't tell me that's a falsehood. Because I lived through it, I saw it, man. Over 60,000 people watched a video when you thought Hawaii was about to be destroyed by nuclear fire, man. By missiles, man. Over 60,000. I witnessed that, I saw it. Okay? But don't tell me. Why you look for that? This is Proverbs 1 and 20. That's crazy, man. These people are so much hypocrites, man. They always talk about they want people that believe in God. I want to be and believe in the Lord. But here it is, you got ministers that believe in the Most High so much so that they're out here preaching it, and we get ridiculed, man.
This is the book of Hosea, chapter 5, verse 15. I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense and seek my face in their affliction. They will seek me early.
Yep, in their affliction. When you catching all hell, you're going to try to seek the Lord early, man. But he's not going to be able to be found, man.
That's right.
You're not going to find the Lord. He ain't going to find us out here on the highways and byways. You get a Psalm on Amos 5 and 8. Can you look up and seek the Lord while he's able to be found? Yeah, when all hell breaks loose, you don't want to seek the Lord, man. But it's going to be too late then, man. It's going to be too late for you then, man. You're not going to find the Lord. You're not going to hear this word. YouTube is going to be shut down. We already at the end of net neutrality. So then what you going to do, man? What you going to have then? Nothing. You scoffers ain't going to have nobody to scoff at. Okay? You're just going to be done. Hey, this is Proverbs 10. Sorry. Proverbs 1 and 24. Because I have called and ye refused, I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded. And that's what the Lord is doing. He used not to stretch out his hand. And you're not regarding, just stretching it out the way. Shrugging his shoulders. You ain't regard this word, man. But those guys are crazy. Don't talk to them. Just keep walking. That's what you say in your mind. Okay?
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verse 6. Seek ye the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, where he may be found.
And this is it. This is seeking the Lord. Coming to the Lord. coming to the altar, asking questions. While he's able to be found, he's able to be found all over the internet. All you gotta do is type in Israelite, GMS, Great Millstone, IUIC, ISUPK, and you're gonna find, at least if you're Israelite, you come to Great Millstone, you're gonna get the whole truth.
That's right.
You come to our videos, you're gonna get nothing but edification. You're able to be found. I mean, the Most High, Yahweh Shemal Shah, is able to be found. Why you got a chance? They already talking about being in the Bible. What you gonna do then? What you gonna do then? Well, all hell breaks loose. Famine, death, destruction, race riots, upheavals of the people. What you gonna do then? You gonna try to seek the Lord, but he's not gonna be able to be found. He's able to be found right now. And where is he able to be found at? Right here on the highways and byways, man.
That's right.
Proverbs 1 and 20. Wisdom cried out. She uttered her voice in the street. In the street. Are we not in the street? We're in the street. This is where wisdom is gonna be found at. But you don't want to get it. She cried from the chief place of concourse and the opens of the gates and the cities. She uttered her words saying, how long, you simple ones, when you love simplicity and you scorners and fools hate knowledge, man? How long would you love simplicity, man? You still calling yourself a Christian, a Muslim, Buddhist? You simple, man. You love simplicity, man.
That's right.
You love to work and talk shit to the men of the Lord. You love simplicity, man. But how long will you love that, man? Verse 26. Verse 25. But ye have set at naught all my counsel, and with none of my reproof. You set the counsel of the Lord at naught. Oh, that shit ain't important. Whatever, man. I got my life to live. I'm gonna do what I wanna do. You got one life to live, so just live it to the fullest. So you set the Lord's counsel at naught. And would none of it approve? Would not hear none of it approve? It's correction. I will also laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. So when your greatest fear coming, the Lord's gonna mock at you, man. He's gonna use us to do it.
That's right.
Oh, look at them niggas, man. I told you I'm 230 niggas. Oh, that's that nigga that was scoffing. That's that nigga that was scoffing. Look. He get tripped over by a fucking tank. Damn. Fuck that, y'all about shimmy, I was shot. When your fear cometh as a desolation and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. See? You're going to seek the Lord early, but you're not going to find him.
That's right.
You're going to seek the Lord early, but you're not going to find him. We're telling you where to find the Lord at right here, man. Why is there nobody here listening? Oh, you offended at I told? You prefer us to break dance and spit on our heads? No, we ain't for the gimmicks, man. Hey, we gonna give you the hard truth and nothing but the truth. So help us, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, man.
That's right. Oh, this is Isaiah 55, verse 6. Seek ye the Lord, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, while he may be found. Call ye upon him. Well, he is near.
Keep reading, brother. Oh, that was it on that?
Let the wicked forsake his ways, and the unrighteous, man his thoughts.
That's talking about Israel, man. Talking about Israel, man.
That was on that.
This is the book of Amos, chapter 5, verse 18. Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord, to what end? Except for you, the day of the Lord shall be darkness and not light.
So woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord. Because you got people that's talking about, I can't wait till the Lord comes back. I'm saved right now, the Lord will have mercy. No. Woe unto you, what you looking for the day of the Lord, man?
Can you read it again?
This is the book of Amos, Chapter 5, verse 18.
Amos 5 and 18, go ahead.
Woe unto you.
Woe unto you.
That desire the day of the Lord.
That desire the day of the Lord.
To what end is it for you?
What is it for you? If you're a so-called Christian, what, why are you looking for the day of the Lord? Is that going to be your salvation? We can tell you emphatically, no, it's not. It's going to be the day of your destruction.
That's right. The day of the Lord is darkness and not light.
Right, you got Christians thinking that the day of the Lord is going to be a day of stars and happiness and feathers and lilies and daisies. You're going to see an Edomite that look like this. You're going to see an Edomite that look like this come out of the sky with his hands out. Oh, Peter, oh, my child, come to me. Come enjoy the kingdom of heaven. What is it? What is it for you, man? If you a heathen, what the hell are you looking for salvation for, man? Salvation ain't for you. This is Jeremiah 3 and 26. Jeremiah 3 and 26. I'm sorry, 3 and 23. Truly in vain is salvation hoped for from the hills and from the multitude of the mountains. Truly, truly in Yahweh, our power, is salvation of Israel.
That's
so,
right.
So salvation is only for Israel. And then it's only for the elect of Israel. So
that's
you gotta
right.
be an Israelite to even get salvation. So what are you looking for salvation for, man? If you're a heathen, yeah, you're a Muslim, you're an Arab, you're a Hamite, you're an Edomite, you're a Moabite and an Ammonite. What are you looking for salvation for? It ain't for you. It's only for the Israelites.
That's right.
Keep reading, bro.
Yep. Amos 5 and 19. As if a man did flee from a lion and a bear met him, or went into a house.
As if a man did flee from a lion or a bear met him. So you're gonna go from one end, all hell breaks loose, you might escape the famine. Oh, I escaped the famine, I got a can of beans. And the sword's gonna get you. So you're gonna be like a man that escaped the lion and a bear met him. And sweat the shit out of you, man. Go ahead.
Or went into a house. And leaned his hand on the wall.
So you got rest. You leaned your hand on the wall. You escaped the lion. You escaped the bear. Got into a house.
And a serpent bit him.
And a serpent bit him. A bite. So you might escape the famine. Then you get the sword. You might escape the sword. Then come the nuclear missile. Bam. You're out of here, man. So what are you expecting the day of the Lord for? What are you looking for the day of the Lord for? What end is it for you? If you ain't right with the Lord, you're going to be destroyed.
That's
you're not
right.
part of his elect, you're going to be destroyed. If you are not an Israelite that's a part of the elect, you will be destroyed.
That's right.
So what is it for you? What are you looking for?
Shall not the day of the Lord be darkness and not light?
Shall not the day of the Lord be darkness and not light, man? Because that's what's coming. Ain't going to be no Project Blue Beam. You're going to see a Chesray Forger. Rappers, Christians, or an amalgamation of all these different religions coming together. No, bro. It's going to be darkness from those nuclear missiles, the smoke. Every city in America is going to be melted. All these big buildings are going to be destroyed. They're going to be brought down.
That's right.
It's going to be anguish and gnashing of teeth. People's skin melting off their bones. Their eye sockets drying in their eyes. Their eyes drying in their eye sockets. Their tongues going away in their mouth. What do you mean? What are you looking for? You don't know the scriptures. The day of the Lord, darkness and not light.
Even very dark and no brightness in it.
Even very dark and no brightness in it. And look, that Edomite right there on that stretcher right there, that's a sign of the times, man. That's a sign of the times here, man. Come and get that, man. Hey, look at Ethan. Y'all see it.
It's only
6
o'clock.
Only 6 o'clock, man. 6:30, man.
I don't know why this ain't charging.
Yeah, it's only 6 o'clock, man. 6:30, man. Hey, but that's America, man. But there ain't gonna be no stretching for you in that day, man. There ain't gonna be no stretching for you in that day, man. Okay?
guy is done, man. That guy is done. You about to see it. That guy is done.
Catatonic. Catatonic with his U.S. Army,
Air Force General, he's done, man. He's all is done, man. And that's America, man. But ain't gonna be no special, man.
Amos 5, verse 21. I hate, I despise your feast days.
Joel chapter 2, verse 1. Yeah, Esau getting carried away off in the stretcher, man. From. Destroyed. For real. Through the mic, man. Through, man.
This is the book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 1. Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand. A day of darkness and of gloominess, a day of clouds and of thick darkness.
Yeah, that day of the Lord, man.
And that day of the Lord is gloomy, man. Yeah, darkness and thick darkness, clouds and gloominess.
And the morning spread upon the mountains, Salaki, as the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people and a strong, there had not been ever the like, neither shall be any more after.
Yeah, so the day of the Lord is going to be a terrible time, man. It's not going to be like no other time, man. That's why the Lord going to open up, man. Yeah, how about Shemal Shah is going to open up with two-thirds of Israel, man? You don't want to hear the word, you want to pop, you want to stop, you want to score, you want to be a indignant. Man, listen, bro. What's coming, there ain't going to be no help for you, man. And that day, 911 ain't going to be around for no stretcher, man. You just going to be done. Wherever you drop is where you stay, man.
That's right. Even to the years of many generations, a fire devoureth before them, and behind them a flame burneth. The land is as a garden, is as the garden of Eden,
yeah,
before,
so before
them.
So before the nuclear missile hit, it's gonna be like this, man. A pure paradise, man. The garden of Eden. But then behind them,
and behind them, a desolate wilderness.
Hey, as soon as they come, boom, 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 boom. Burn, burn, baby, burn, man. That's what's gonna happen to America, man. It's gonna be a wasteland.
That's right. Yeah, and nothing shall escape them.
So nothing's gonna escape them, man. T.D. Jakes, that nigga Nate, you ain't gonna be able to get away on no plane, and nothing's gonna escape them, man. Nothing's gonna escape the destruction, man. Nobody or anything. The only one that's gonna escape is the elect of Israel, man. That's it. That's it. So hey, man, we about to get out of here. Hey, you got any closing statements? Hey, man, so with that, man, hey, stay strong, man. We almost fucked up out of this piece, man. So with that, we want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rakab, Wadash. Double honor to the apostles and elders at Great Millstone. Keep the word, keep the sincerity, and rule the well. Salutations to our fellow Africans. Keep pushing, keep striving. We almost out of here. Shalom.
Shalom.